So at last, welcome back to the Analysis 2 course right here. Last time we have talked about Taylor series and a few expansions of special functions like the exponential function, for example. And today we are going to take a look at something which is really fundamental, and you are going to find it in many branches of mathematics. Today we are actually going to derive Euler's formula and its connection to Euler's identity today. I hope you are really excited for what you are going to do today. Mr. Dodson, I've got a question.
Yes, Andrew?
In the first line right there, is that supposed to be a limit?
No, it's obviously supposed to be a k.
But how would a k right here make any sense in this context, seriously?
So are you talking about the zeta right here, which looks like a curly bracket, which is actually a xi in disguise?
I'm talking about what's written up there in the upper left corner, Mr. Dodson.
Oh, up here. That's actually supposed to be a sign.
Welcome to your first year in grad school, fellow students. You can finally call yourself mathematicians. You have grown to be adults now. You see, since we've exhausted our repertoire of, well, Greek, Arabic, Phoenician, and also Hebrew letters, we can finally start using the real stuff, the good stuff. We can finally make use of Japanese kanji and Chinese symbols. So I hope you're excited for that. Enjoy your ride in grad school. It's going to be absolute fun. So, Jonathan, we are actually done with everything except for this last integral right here. So that's the last thing on the analysis homework that we actually have to do. Let us get started here. I'm giving you the paper. Jonathan, please, do something. I'm trying this now for 45 minutes straight. It's going nowhere. I tried everything we have covered in our anal class. Please, do something. Help me with this.
Andrew, they actually gave a hint about how to solve this integral. Sorry that I didn't tell you. It says you should check for symmetry on the integrand.
So you said symmetry here, so what happens if we plug in negative x into here? That's going to give us negative the integrand. Oh, bruh. So students, here's the new exercise sheet. I want you to submit your solutions up until next Tuesday. I'm going to put the exercise sheets right here on the table and you can grab them after the class is actually over. One question, Mrs. Kelly. On exercise number 2, can we make use of Gauss's divergence theorem? We have already used and applied it in analysis 3, so that would be pretty quite useful and would make the exercise way easier for all of us. Oh, you were serious? No way you can use something that you have already learned in a different course. Please do everything from scratch. So I've been doing all the courses that we basically have to do, except for a handful. Let me check which ones I still have to do before I can finish my bachelor's. That's just applied maths and the mandatory statistics class that everyone has to take. Oh boy. That's not good. Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome to the first lesson of applied mathematics, the only type of mathematics that's actually going to earn you money once you've finished your studies. Before we can actually get started with all the things we are going to do during the semester, I would like to introduce a very important theorem that is going to help you through your studies. It's called the fundamental theorem of engineering, and it's really important.
Andrew, would you be so kind to present exercise number 3 to the class?
Yeah, sure. Coming. So we are basically done with everything that we wanted to cover for today. There's only one little thing left. Also, before I forget it, after class is actually done, you can come to my desk and actually get yourself the topics for your examination talks. Sit down, Andrew, sit down. I'm so glad you are finally doing something right in your life, that you are doing a math course for once. So I'm really glad you're attending this course. So what you actually have to do is, I got my laptop right here. You're going to give a talk about inter-universal theory. Maybe you have never heard about it before. It's pretty trivial. So there's not much to talk about right there. And I'm going to send you a PDF file, which is just a one-page long paper, covering the whole topic. It's pretty trivial in itself, and yeah, I guess I'm going to give you 2 weeks from now on, and then you can actually give the examination talk to the whole class. So let's see what she actually gave me, right? Why the heck is this paper only one page in size, but consists two pages of references? Something's wrong here. Why are all the proofs left as an exercise to the reader? Do I really have to read all of those books to understand everything that's in here?
Yeah.
I'm finally done. Only one proof left. Took me approximately 69 hours to get to this point. Okay. It refers to this book. I know I got it from the library already. Page number pi. Okay. Oh boy, look at that, Andrew. I spent the whole week perfecting this week's algebra homework. Seriously, I spent the whole week. It took me 8 pages, but this time I'm going to get all the points. Seriously, all 48 points, full marks. I'm going to do it. That's going to be absolutely perfect. So class, you can collect your homework after class is actually done. Was quite disappointing actually what you delivered this week, even more disappointing than what you deliver in the normal case. Seriously, Andrew, the professor is exaggerating, right? 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 There's no way I only received 1 out of 48 points. Why, once again, only 1 out of 48 points happens every damn week? Mr. Andrews, I've got a question. Here? I've got a question, mate. It's so weird filming a 1 second scene just because I forgot filming it a different day. My face when Andrew had a sudden urge to change his clothes for one scene. Oh boy.